All right. I believe this is part 6 of the airbrushing lionfish. We're going to work on this area here, getting these dark spots that are in here. We're going to use, again, one of Gerald Mendez's FX, texture effects. And this is a little bit larger one because there's some larger areas in here. I'm going to spray. We're using a, again, the Grisaille Createx Grays. We're using the Neutral 5 this time. So I'm going to try to get this area a little bit darker. I am keeping it up off of there so that I get the softer edge on there, because on the original reference, got a little splatter there. Paint came out a little bit too heavy. And several ways you can get rid of that, just like I did there. Just cut back on the air a little bit. Seems like the paint's gotten a little bit thin. Didn't mix up all the way. Again, try to get some of these shapes. Again, just want to get a light coat in there. We'll darken those in when we put color to it. See, just looking around for the different darker areas to start putting those shapes that are in between those. Said lifting it up off the surface there, just a little bit, probably 1/8 of an inch or so, just to get. Soft edges on it, but still a nice shape. Just put the light dusting on there of the color. Again, like I said, we can use some of these edges if we need to. Some other areas along here. got pretty much the areas we want. Back here, clean up some of these edges that still need to be hard. Oops, sorry about that. See, the camera's right behind my head. Sometimes I just move, don't realize it's there. Trying to redefine that hard edge there. In the reference, it's got a really strong white highlight. So I'm putting that in. And I'm using a bamboo skewer. That's all this is. Sharpened it first with a pencil sharpener. Then moved it over to a sandpaper pad. Get a nice tip on it. Now you could do the same thing, you know, with an X-Acto knife. And, you know, I highly recommend if you're doing with the X-Acto knife and stuff, experiment. Try different blades. With most X-Acto knife blades too, you have to figure out which side of the blade and which point side. You've got best scrape the paint off, because there is a grain to it. And one side you could scrape for days and not get a real good edge down. And then on other days, and the other side of it, you'll find that all of a sudden you're cutting through it like it's butter, which is really what you want, something nice and smooth. So you've got good control of what you're doing. I tend to use a blade or a scalpel for hair, fur, things of that nature. They got really fine lines. Anything wider than, you know, than a hairline, I'll use a wood skewer like this or bamboo. And seem to have a pretty good success with it. Like I said, I'll also go back over it very lightly with a soft eraser to pick up some of that edge residue if I want to keep it, you know, white. Or whatever the color of the surface is that you're trying to maintain. See what else we can work on there with this medium. So we're gonna use some of that edge work that we've been doing for the stripes. There's a bunch of that going on here, so might as well get into it. Okay, got a little splash there. Not quite working like it should. Trigger seems to be sticking a little bit, so we're gonna switch over. Just dump the paint over into one of my hard-earned stain bags. And put the other one up and see if we can't press on with this spraying. I do that quite frequently. I have a setup of about four brushes. Usually I like to keep one set, Harder and Steinbeck, Infinity CR Plus. It's got a 0.15 millimeter needle in it. So it gets really good fine lines, nice fine spray pattern, but I've got two of those, and I'll keep one for lights and one for darks. So it's kind of a purple personal preference. Makes cleaning a little bit easier, knowing what you're going to. Well, one thing with the hard-earned steamback, I don't have the MAC valve right there underneath everything, so it's a little bit harder to get to, but I do have a MAC valve on it. You can see here's the MAC valve right here. That'll control the air. Like I said, you gotta just work with it a little bit differently. In order to control the air, but it's an extremely nice line, nice spray pattern on it. So I really like the way it feels and works. Come back in like we did. Put some of these organic shapes in there. Try not to same process. I got some areas that we still want to keep Oh, and this one, see if I can show you. Cut it into a wedge, and that'll give me a broader line, but still a nice edge to it. So I don't have to be trying to scrape away large areas. With just a tiny tip. Plus, with it being a wedge and flat kind of like that, it doesn't dig into the surfaces as much. And kind of leave those rows and lines that you'll run into when you're trying to clean up area on soft surfaces like this. You can also go back in, which I normally do too, with a more aggressive along that edge. Kind of clean that up, but still give it a nice organic look to it. Doing little tiny circles, varying your pressure. You'll get that either maintain that organic edge. Because what happens is the eraser will take the, be aggressive on the top layer of paint that's lighter, which is really what you're trying to get rid of. And then when you press down a little bit more, you can work on the harder edge. Another tool for erasing. This is a fiberglass eraser that again works real good in creating those fuzzy lines. You can use it by dotting, since it's a bunch of fiberglass strands on the end. If you go straight on, it gives kind of like a little dot pattern. If you scrub like I'm doing here, circles, kind of softens it up, gives it that soft granular look. Now you gotta be real careful with this, because this can be extremely aggressive on your surfaces. Not only that, you don't want to be up close to it. You can breathe in the little fiberglass fibers that it generates, because it's just wearing away. Again, you really need to clean up some areas. Especially trying to keep that surface nice and smooth with no textures coming back in real lightly. Dusting over this area will get those real fine stray pieces of paint. Again, another great tool for working with hair. You're trying to soften some of the hair, soften the edges as it blurs out. Again, we'll come back in and work with those edges a little bit, a little bit darker color in there, and then you'll be able to see some of that contrast that needs to be in there. But we're still, you know, just trying to lay a base coat down. Gives you something to work with, something to erase on, things of that nature. To spray, must be this color is just not wanting to cooperate today. And again, you'll find that happens with just about any paint. All right, we're gonna pause it here and take a short break to see if we can get these airbrushes working a little bit better. So I'll return as quick as I can.